morning, AK. Hi, I'm Jose Altamirano.
And I'm Caroline Sewell.
This week, we take a look at the nursing program, the Lower State Volleyball Championship, and our English teacher, Dr. Hostetler.
Live from Hive, this is AHS News.
Over the last week or so, we have investigated the Aiken High Health Science Program. Here's a deeper look on what the program entails.
Well, our health science program starts off first and second period. So first period, we normally go over the subject that we're learning. So like today, we're learning about EKGs. So we'll go about EKGs today, and then later on in the lab for second period, we'll go in there and actually hook ourselves up to the leads and physically read it.
I would say, yeah. Sorta, but like, not as much as I do now. Like, I always just said it to people just to like say it, you know. Like, but now it's like, okay, I actually want to do that because it's really fun and my teacher is great.
I first went to school for elementary education, and then I decided that I did not like elementary education, so I started working in. Well, I was working in the healthcare field. While I was in college, I was a PCT, while I was in college. And I decided that being a elementary education teacher was not something I wanted to do, but I always knew that I wanted to teach. So I went to nursing school and I got my bachelor's in nursing, and then I just went back and I got my master's in nursing education. So now I get to do my two favorite things, the healthcare field and teach.
The health science program is a great way to be career ready after graduation.
They get their PCT certification, which is the patient care tech, which allows them to work in the hospital, taking vital signs, giving baths, doing EKGs, drawing blood. They could also get their pharmacy tech certification. So that means that they'll learn about all kinds of different medications, and then they can go and they can work in like Walgreens or CVS in a pharmacy and get paid. You know, some places pay up to $18 an hour as a pharmacy tech. And then everybody in the health science program who at least takes health science 1 and 2 will get CPR certified and first aid certified and stop the bleed certified. And then they'll get their OSHA 10 certification. So you have PCT, pharmacy tech, first aid, CPR, OSHA 10, and stop.
If you are an Aiken High student and want to look into the nursing program here at Aiken High, you can talk to your guidance counselor or Ms. Greist.
It helps prepare students who want to go into a nursing career.
I think it's important for Aiken High to have a nursing program because it gives students better opportunities to pursue a career they want to, especially at Aiken High, as USC Aiken. I think that's why.
It allows for a diverse group of people to have the same opportunities that they might not get elsewhere.
Our volleyball team took victory at the Lower State Championship last Tuesday.
Let's have an inside look on their achievements and plans for state championships.
Aiken High School's volleyball team played Hilton Head High on the night of November 2nd.
Yeah!
Here's the amazing moment where AHS won the lower state championship. Come support the AHS volleyball team this Saturday, November 6th at 6 p.m. at Pickens High School.
But the fire is so delightful, and since we know
Feliz Navidad, Feliz Navidad, Feliz Navidad, Prospero.
Happy holidays.
Dr. Hostetler, one of Aiken High School's English teachers, has just received her doctorate.
Let's take a closer look at her success.
After 5 years of hard work and dedication, Kayla Hostetler earned her doctorate. She has completed an immense amount of work to get to this position.
It was on using culturally relevant pedagogy strategies within a blended hybrid environment that happened last school year.
There are many steps to earn a doctorate.
Basically, I had to apply to USC for the program, and they only—it's a PhD in language and literacy, so they don't submit, like they don't accept everyone. They only accept three people a year, and so I had to go through this intensive interview process. I had to do writing samples, and then I got the notification that they picked me. And then I had to do—I believe it was 80 hours or 80 something hours of coursework. And get all of that done, and then you have to do what is called a comp defense, where you say, this is what I want to do with my research, here is like 80 pages proving this is what I want to do, and then you get grilled and questioned, and then they tell you if you pass that, and then once you pass that, you have to submit your study to IRB, which is this review board, to make sure that it's not going to harm anyone you're working with, the participants. And then after you pass that, you actually do the study, collect the data, analyze it, and then you have to write that dissertation. So my manuscript was 258 pages. And I'm an English teacher, and I enjoy writing, but the revision process on that was so intensive. My advisor would, just like I do with students, would send back my chapters with all these red marks everywhere and fix this, don't do that, and then I'd fix it, and then she'd tell me to change it back, and then I'd change it back. And then after that process, then I defended, like I did on Wednesday, in front of four women, and you do a 30-minute presentation on all your research, and then they send you out of the room, and they call you back in, and they grill you with questions. And I was successful at answering their questions. And then you get your PhD D, but you still have to make some little edits to that manuscript, and that's it. So when before I started the process, I was just newly married and I did not have any children, and not that they were a difficulty, but it was quite a surprise to find out like 3 months into the program that I was pregnant with my first daughter. I also lost my grandfather, who was my father during the dissertation process, and so that was really difficult to keep going and trying to do that. And then I had another daughter, so it was a lot of juggling and trying to keep going and facing every challenge, and sometimes I was like, maybe this isn't worth it, but it definitely was worth sticking it out. So you have to balance working and doing clubs and volunteering and having kids and doing research, so it's a lot.
She's been able to have both of our children during this time. She's been able to accomplish it with a death in the family, a major death in the family, and I'm very proud of her.
One of her former teacher interns, Rachel Long, shares her experience learning from Dr. Hostetler.
Well, she was my mentor teacher when I was a student intern, and most of what I do now, I learned from her. She gave me a lot of cool ideas. She was really helpful and supportive, and she let me kind of take over in a way that wasn't overwhelming or overbearing for me, and so she helped me learn throughout the entire process, and she still does. I think for whenever we were in the old building, my favorite part was just having fun with her and the students and really learning how to be a teacher in an environment that really wasn't, like, it wasn't this big, new, fabulous building, but she still showed me that you can still be a good teacher under different circumstances and love all of these students regardless of where they come from. And we just had a lot of fun. We still do.
Just anytime she needed me to be there by her side to help with anything, I would try to drop everything I could to help her do whatever she needed to do. Most of the time was being there for the children, especially during the summer of COVID, just making sure that she could finish up her comps so that she could go on and move on with her dissertation.
Yeah, I know she's been doing this for so long and it's finally done, and we've all been there for her, and so it's nice to see that she's finally done and relieved.
This has been Tamaya Deeper with AHS News.
And now for this week's announcements.
In conjunction with the Golden Harvest Food Bank, the Aiken High School Key Club will collect canned or non-perishable food items to help fight hunger in our community. Please drop off donations in the spooky box located on the foyer of the course room D110.
Any student interested in the Governor's School of Science and Math, applications are open. The deadline will be February 15th. Information packets are located in the counseling office.
Tune into this week's podcast highlights, the pros and cons of social media and the impact on Aiken High student body mental and physical health, as well as performance in academics and extracurriculars.
That's all for this week on AHS News.
Thanks for watching, and go Hornets!